sex for grade has been an issue, the very big one Nigerian institutions have made. So what is UI doing to make sure that such is not reported?
Well, there are two major structures are in place. We have a gender mainstreaming office. Last night I called the focal person, Professor Ayidagbe, and we discussed the value of this news that broke about the two universities in West Africa, Lagos and Legon. So we have the gender mainstreaming office, we have a gender policy. We also have a sexual harassment policy. If I remember, the sexual harassment policy was developed when Professor Odegide was Deputy Vice Chancellor of Academic. In fact, she insisted that the two policies should not be matched, that the sexual harassment policy should be separate from the gender policy. So, I mean, there are structures in place. And as you can imagine, the university has zero tolerance for sexual harassment. We think it's not right. So students have opportunity to report. Because if reports are not made, then it will be difficult for us to, bring anybody to book. And like I also mentioned in passing during the interview, my own position is that you are not going to be writing any law because of a particular, of course you can learn from the experience. But if there are existing laws and somebody has flouted that rule, then you should be sent to be implementing the rules. Otherwise, we will not be sending the correct signal. So if any member of staff is accused, and he or she will be given a fair hearing, and if found guilty, then we have to look at the books. What are the regulations? Because if my daughter is here, I also won't like her to be harassed by my wife. So I think that is the issue. If anybody flouts the regulation that has been put in place, then he or she should be made to face the music. Because there are also instances where male lecturers will also be harassed. Even though most of the time it's female students that the receiving end. We have zero tolerance.
Has there ever been any report of such, maybe to the Senate or this?
Actually, I think there was one. Recent, maybe this year even, at the Yoruba Language Center. You know, they bring some American students who come there for a short period of time. So there was a report of a student, a postgraduate student, who was one of their teachers at the Yoruba Language Center. I cannot remember his name now. But he was expelled a few months ago. But there was a report. He came there to defend himself. We were not satisfied with his explanation. So, there was no amount of pleading that they were prepared to listen to. So he was expelled. You can go and check the records just this year at the Yoruba Language Center.
Okay, so what assurance do you have for your students who want to blow the whistle, who want to report?
Yeah, they have opportunities. In fact, because I'm a man, they may not be able to open up to me. They can always approach the gender mainstreaming office, which, as you can imagine, is headed by a female lecturer. So they can always confide in her. And maybe I think it's that. That's why the head of this is a woman, because Ayelaji is the gender focal person. So they can report. And so to that extent, they are blowing the whistle. And whoever is, if it's an allegation, the person is still presumed innocent. So he or she will be given opportunity to make a defense. But if the committee is not convinced, then we apply the appropriate sanction. Of course, there's always opportunity for the person to appeal to the governing council. The student disciplinary committee or the staff disciplinary committee is not the final arbiter, it's the council. Because all of us were employed by a council. So the council has the oversight function over appointments, promotions, and disciplinary matters. But we, as a matter of policy, we have a zero tolerance for sexual harassment. And like I told you, there's a specific document, sexual harassment policy, maybe in the last 15 years that it was.
Has it been reviewed lately?
It was reviewed. Yeah, it was even reviewed this year. It was both documents, the gender mainstreaming office as well as the sexual. That's a very good question. Both documents were recently reviewed, in the light of a new development. So, maybe 20 years ago, social media was not that popular. So it has just been recently, this year, that was approved by both Senate and the Council of the University.
So is this supposed to be a warning to both the staff and students?
Yeah, of course. You have to be forewarned is to be forearmed, so that people will end up claiming ignorance. Ignorance will not be a defense. So the policy, I'm sure, is available on our website. The director of ITEMS is here. He can confirm that we have those two documents on our website. So it's a public document, and anybody can access either of those two documents.